Hello, my most amazing artist. I hope you enjoyed the book, Balloons Over Broadway. Today, we're going to be creating a scene from New York City. They have big, tall buildings. And if you've ever seen the Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade, you notice that they have lots of balloons that people carry. And they have to have a lot of people that hold the strings because there's lots of helium in those balloons. And what we're going to do is we're going to create some buildings. And then next week, we're going to add a balloon here. So you'll see that. What I want you to do is start by adding 4 or 5 buildings. We're going to keep this drawing with the Sharpie very simple, and we're going to add details next week. So what I would do is I would just draw the top of a building, the side of a building.
You will do that all the way across your page. Like I said, you might need 3 to 4, maybe 5 buildings. So draw them up and down, connect them, because they would be connected in New York City. Draw some tall, some short.
Okay, so now we're going to add windows. So we might add doors. And we want to make these buildings look very tall. So therefore, our doors are going to be small on the bottom, okay? We're going to also add some windows. So this is where I want you to take your time. Be careful. Make this look good. Like, I'm trying to make these windows all around the same size. And I'm trying to make them go in a line so that it looks like a building. So do this here. And I'm taking my time on this, but we're going to make it very simple. You notice I'm just using rectangles.
Just keep this part today simple. We are going to add details next week. All right, add windows. Add a variety. Don't just add the same looking windows. Keep it simple, but add some different shapes of windows and different styles. Then you are going to be ready to paint. Now, I like to paint around the windows. I paint up, down, right in between them. Just do your best. You have a small brush. If your brush is not small enough, let me know and I will get you a smaller one. I like to paint just underneath all the straight edges, down all the straight sides, and that helps me paint it neatly. When you get done with all the buildings, you can paint the sky and then paint the windows. It helps to paint all the buildings in the sky first because that gives your buildings time to dry before you paint the windows, and it's less likely that your paint will mix and muddy itself up. So paint the entire paper and you'll be done for today.
Okay, I'm finished. I'm gonna put this on the drying rack. And remember, we can fit 4 of these on the drying rack at a time. Have fun.